Hello, welcome to My Student Support System. In today's class, we will discuss about a practical procedure, oxygen inhalation. This lecture is in English, and if you want to study in Hindi, just click on I button and you will get link of Hindi lecture, or you can directly visit to channel My Student Support System. What is oxygen inhalation? Oxygen is also known as medical gas. It is needed by each cell of our body for its metabolism and making its energy. It is transported with the blood from our lungs to the each cell. Without oxygen, our cells tend to die. Oxygen inhalation is defined as the administration of oxygen from a cylinder or piped oxygen system in the hospitals to the patient to maintain proper oxygenation of tissues and cells. What are the objectives of oxygen inhalation? Why oxygen is needed, or why the oxygen should be administered to the patient? Oxygen inhalation helps in relieving the conditions related to tissue hypoxia. Hypoxia means decreased oxygen level. Oxygen inhalation also helps in correcting hypoxemia. Hypoxemia means low level of oxygen in the blood. And oxygen inhalation facilitates to maintain normal metabolism of the tissue if it is diminished due to hypoxia. And what are indications of oxygen inhalation? When the client or patient needs oxygen? Oxygen therapy is like medical therapy or medicines. It should be administered as per prescription of treating physician or as per standing instructions and policies of the institution during emergency. Following are the indications for oxygen inhalation. These includes shock and circulatory failure, breathlessness or labored breathing, hypoxia due to pneumonia, patients under effects of anesthesia, hypoxia due to high altitude, cyanosis means bluish discoloration of the skin due to lack of oxygen, severe anemia also leads to hypoxia, severe hemorrhage means bleeding, and severe lung injury due to any trauma or infection such as in COVID-19 pneumonia. What are the methods of inhalation? How oxygen is administered? There are many methods, and the method of oxygen inhalation depend on the condition of the patient, oxygen concentration required by the patient, and facilities available. The method of oxygen inhalation includes, number one, oxygen inhalation by nasal catheter. Nasal catheters are very small, flexible tubes which are inserted into the nose, up to nasopharynx. After insertion, it is held in place by adhesive plasters. This is the nasal catheter. Here the oxygen tubing is attached, and this part is very flexible, and it will go inside the nasal cavity and up to the uvula. Nasal catheters needs to be changed every 8 hours because it may block due to secretions, and even it is also painful during insertion. These are some disadvantages. Otherwise, it is good. By this method, 30% oxygen concentration can be delivered by using 1 to 4 liter of oxygen. So low flow of oxygen, good oxygenation is maintained. Oxygen inhalation by nasal cannula. Nasal cannula is a flexible device having two protrude openings. So this is cannula. There are two openings, one for each nostril. This will go in the nostrils, and these will encircle around the mouth like this. Okay. And here we can apply tape also. This is attached with a long tube. This is long tube. The flow rate of oxygen is kept 1 to 4 LPM. LPM means liter per minute. If it is used without humidifier, or 4 to 10 LPM if it is used with humidifier. Next is on oxygen inhalation by mask method. Oxygen mask is a flexible device fitting over the nose and mouth. And it delivers humidified oxygen. The type of mask to be used depend upon the client's requirement, and it is clearly stated in the physician's order. We can check. Normally, a simple face oxygen mask is used. Other masks are the mask with the reservoir bag, ventilator mask, and venturi mask. Simple mask. This is a simple mask. This is oxygen tubing. Here there is a nasal clip and oxygen. This is air vent. So simple mask deliver 40 to 60% oxygen at a flow rate of 10 liter per minute. It has a metal nose clip and air vent on the sides, both sides. It is the simplest form of oxygen mask, and many times in the hospitals or wards you come across this mask. Then oxygen mask with reservoir bag. So here this is a reservoir bag. So when we attach with the oxygen source, some oxygen is kept here. So this is a reservoir for oxygen. This oxygen mask provides 95 to 100% oxygen. It also known as non-rebreather oxygen mask. It has one-way valve which allow exhaled air to go into the environment. So this is one-way valve. So exhaled carbon dioxide and air will go outside in the environment, and pure oxygen will go inside the lungs. Venturi mask. This Venturi mask is like a simple mask, but there are some attached special color-coded valves which allows mixing of air with the oxygen. Venturi mask is able to deliver wide range of concentration of the oxygen and air, 24 to 55%, at variable amount of oxygen flow rate, that is 4 to 15 liter per minute. It delivers oxygen blended with the environmental air using the color-coded valves. Then oxygen inhalation by tent. Normally this is very less used, but sometimes we can use. Oxygen tent is like a canopy, and this device fit over the bed and covers the patient. This is transparent, and we are able to observe the patient during the oxygen inhalation process. The tent is first filled with the oxygen, and then a steady flow rate of 4 to 5 LPM is maintained. It will deliver 40 to 50% oxygen. Then there is oxygen inhalation by hood method. This is a plastic device. There is a small hole. It is kept on the head, and oxygen pipe is attached here. Normally this method is used for children. Now we will come to the procedure. We will prepare the articles before starting the procedure. For this we need oxygen source. It may be a cylinder. This is oxygen cylinder. And we may use piped oxygen which is supplied in the hospitals or wards. Then we need oxygen flow meter. This is flow meter. It is having a valve, and there is a ball which shows the flow of oxygen, LPM. how much oxygen is flowing. And then humidifier. This is a humidifier. This contains water. So when oxygen flow through this, it is humidified. And we can also ensure that yes, oxygen is flowing. Then nasal cannula, catheter or mask as per order. Lubricating jelly. These small articles are in the oxygen inhalation tray. Then oxygen tubing. This is a tubing for connections. Ball with water. Adhesive tape. Cotton applicator to clean the nasal cavity. Normal saline in the bowl. Kidney tray and paper bag and tissue paper. Now steps of procedure. First of all, we should apply all five rites of medication administration, as oxygen is also considered a medication. Right patient, right route, right drug. Then explain the procedure to the patient and relatives also, and give instructions regarding safety precautions required during the oxygen inhalation. Place the patient in comfortable position. A Fowler's position can be given, it is best. Otherwise, spine position can also be given. Wash hands before starting the procedure. And then prepare oxygen system by attaching oxygen tubing to the humidifier. This is attached to flow meter, and finally it is attached to the oxygen cylinder or oxygen source. Check the flow of oxygen by placing the tip of tubing into the bowl of water by and opening the valve. Then there will be bubbles in the bowl, so means oxygen is flowing properly. And at this time we can also check the bubbles in the humidifier bottle also. Attach tubing to the catheter, mask or cannula, whichever method we are using. If we are using cannula, just place the cannula near nostrils, and then we will take the tubings from here and we will fix it behind the head, and also we attach the pipes with the help of plaster on the cheek. Okay, in this way it will attach, it will be attached. And if you are using catheter, then it should be inserted into the nasal cavity. And for this, we will measure how much it will go inside. And for measuring the length, first we will measure from bridge of the nose to the earlobe. Okay, so this will give exact length for the particular patient. Then we will apply jelly on the catheter and we will insert. Okay, up to the mark which we have just measured. And when it will reach, we can check. It should reach up to uvula. And we will ask the client to open the mouth and we will check behind the uvula. There should be the tip of catheter. And then we will fix here on the first on the nose and then on the forehead, or sometime on the cheek also, with the help of plaster. And then we will open the flow meter to start the oxygen. And if mask is used, again the mask is applied over nose and mouth, and we will check it is fixed. And there are steps given. We will fix with the help of straps, and then we will secure the oxygen tubing with the help of plasters with the bed, so that these are not kinked or pulled accidentally. Then we will start the oxygen. We will check the flow rate. It should be as per order. And then stay with the client till he feels comfortable or she feels comfortable. And we will also cover the patient up to the level of chest. We will not cover the mouth, or so that we can observe continuously that proper placement of this mask or cannula is there or not. After the procedure, we will remove all the articles that we placed there. We will replace them to their proper place after proper cleaning, and we can discard the disposal soiled articles. Evaluate the client's progress by checking the vital signs regularly and record the procedure in nursing record with effectiveness and present condition of the client. Thank you students for watching this video. For more such videos or lectures, you can subscribe the channel, you can like Facebook page, and for making your notes, you can visit mynursingstudents.blogspot.com and search for your topic. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and join Facebook group Nursing. Thank you. Have a nice day.